A bit earlier, you changed some permissions on the authorized key file and the .ssh directory using a command called chmod. But what exactly does that mean? Let's dive a bit deeper into how Linux manages file permissions. I've listed the contents of the student's home directory, and we're going to look at three pieces of information provided here. The first column we've looked at briefly before. Remember, the D means that this is a directory. The dash means that it's a file. Now, you might think that there are 9 additional spaces here for information, but what's actually happening is there are 3 separate sections, and each of those sections has 3 pieces of information. Let's break out this entry here for bash.rc. The 3 individual entries are rw-, r-, and r-. Let's go ahead and label each of these entries. This first one I'm labeling owner, then group, and finally everyone. This means the owner can read and write the file. The dash here indicates that the owner cannot execute the file. If they could, there would be an X here. Users within the group can read this file, but they cannot write or execute it. Finally, everyone can read this file, but they cannot write or execute it.